Sim. Não tem nem lá aí. Desconectado. Não. E a coisa é online. So, fuiste online. Your name is. Can you hear me? Olina. එදා සර්වනාද කරගමයි අමෙරිකාවට මම කිව්වනේ ලෝකවල එක්කෙනා ජීවිතයට හැකියාවල් තියෙනවා නේද සමාධින්ට ඉන්න කියන්න පුළුවන් එක්කන් ඉන්න පුළුවන් නටන්න පුළුවන් පෝස් කරන ඉන්නවා ඔකලොත් පුළුවන් මොන හරි දේවල් ආ සමහර අය ඉන්නවා කතා කියනවා කවි කියනවා මේක තමයි හොඳම කරන්නේ ඒ වගේ मलतना Pues al estarte, algo a la más, o por lo menos más, sube en este que lo va a dar por el freno, había que estar en el nombre, right? It's like we have discussed, finished all the basics of limits, right? Limits of a function. But I gave a few questions for homework, including past table problems from 2011, right? 2019. So today I think better we discuss them. But I think I have missed one example last day. Did I give this? Limit as x goes to 0. Sin inverse x divided by x. Did I give this question last day? I don't remember. If not, you can do it now. Okay, today I'm going to give 2-3 new questions before starting homework, discussing homework questions. I give 2-3 new questions. After that, we can start homework to discuss homework and also ask their problems, right? Will you try this? I do 2 minutes. Do this. Good evening to you. You have connected just now. So you can try this. I give 2-3 more questions before starting all this discussing homework. Now it's sine inverse x over x as x goes to 0. Right? How to start? What is your approach? When it's sine inverse, maybe cos inverse, tan inverse, even L and X, the inverse functions, how do you start usually? You remember? In a problem like this, what we learn in trigonometry, many questions, sums we have learned under inverse functions, right? Basically, our method is, if there is an inverse function like this, we start by substituting some angle, right? Say I take some alpha cosine inverse x. Then immediately we write, as we learned earlier, you start by using like some substitute, alpha equals sine inverse x. Then immediately we will write sine alpha equals x, right? So the sine inverse x can be replaced by alpha. If you do so, this x can be replaced by sine alpha. So it becomes alpha over sine alpha, and now it's like you have substituting, you get like limit as x goes to 0, sine inverse x over x equals. This sine inverse x, we can replaced by alpha, right? Replaced by alpha and x by sine alpha. So alpha over sine alpha, it has some shape now, but thing is here the limit. X goes to 0, but we have substituted in alpha, the limit, this limit we have to express in alpha. See what happens to alpha? As x goes to 0, what will be the limit of the alpha? If x goes to 0, what happens to sine alpha? Here, you see that as x goes to 0, sine alpha will go to x equals sine alpha. As x goes to 0, sine alpha will go to 0, right? Therefore, what happens to alpha? As sine alpha goes to 0, what happens to alpha? Where will go alpha? Yeah, what do you think? As x goes to 0, that's what you are given, limit as x goes to 0. So as x goes to 0, sine alpha, x equals sine alpha, therefore sine alpha will go to 0. If sine alpha goes to 0, where will go within alpha? Alpha will tend to? What do you think? Your answer? If x goes to 0, what happens to alpha? Alpha goes to 0, same setting, and also I think Linara. And Olina, right? As sine alpha goes to 0, you say alpha goes to 0. Can't it be 5? Can't it be minus 5? Can't it be 2 pi or minus 2 pi? Then 3 pi, minus 3 pi. Sine alpha goes to 0, alpha can tend to any of these. Pi, 2 pi, maybe minus pi, minus 2 pi, minus 3 pi, plus 3 pi. So it can be anything. At first sight, it can be anything. Now, how do you say it is definitely 0? Your answer is correct. What is the reason? So here we are coming through. Inverse functions. When we define sine inverse x, when you say alpha equals sine inverse x, do you remember? We have conditions. This alpha should be, when you say alpha equals sine inverse x, this alpha we select between minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. To be 1 to 1 and 1 to, right? Especially to be 1 to 1, alpha should be between minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. So then can it be a pi? 2 pi, minus pi, minus 2 pi, 3 pi, minus 2, something like that? No. The only option is alpha tends to 0 because alpha is defined via an inverse function. So the only option is alpha goes to 0. Only possibility is alpha goes to 0. So this, when you substitute for this sine inverse x replaced by alpha, x by sine alpha, then the limit as x goes to 0 will change it to alpha goes to 0. Now it's very much the standard form. Well, if you want, you can write it upside down, 1 over. If you want, you can write it like this. It's even without that, you can get the answer. If you want, you express it like this, turning upside down, sine alpha over alpha, now exactly the form of the limit that we have. So this thing is equal to 1. Ultimately, the answer is 1. Right? Okay, will you please take down this? I'll give one or two more questions before discussing homework. Okay, please take it down then. And after that, I'll give one or two more. Okay, can we go to the next? Limit as x goes to 0, 1 minus cos of the angle is sin x, cos of sin x divided by sin x, 1 minus cos of sin x divided by sin x as x goes to 0. Okay, I give 2 minutes, you try it and give me the answer. Limit as x goes to 0, 1 minus cos of sin x over sin x. I gave a similar question last week. Similar sum last week. So you can do this easily. Yeah, enter your answer as soon as you find it. Last year I gave a similar problem where it's like cos theta, 1 minus cos theta or sin theta. I gave a similar question from last year. The other difference is sin x is there, but still not that much different to that. So we use the formula cos 2 theta, cos theta equals 1 minus 2 sin squared theta over 2. So 1 minus cos theta is equal to 1 minus cos theta equals is equal to 2 sin squared theta over 2. We used this formula last day to work at the same problem. So this thing, the whole thing, numerator can be replaced by 2 sin squared. So instead of theta, we have sin x. It's sin x over 2. Divided by sin x. Limit for the moment as x goes to 0. So remember the theorem we have, right? That's the tool we have. Limit as x goes to 0. Sin x over x is equal to 1. So that's our tool, right? So we have to connect it here somehow. It's not that hard. Here looks like we have for the moment sin of, we take one of them, that is square, we'll take one of them. Sin of sin x divided by 2. Sin of sin x divided by 2. The other sin x, sin of sin x by 2, I'll take separately. Sin of sin x over 2, I take that separately. And one of these I take here. Then, divided by, we have sin x. We have sin x here. We have sin x, but you would like to see, not sin x, but sin x divided by 2. So you can borrow this 2. So that can be written here. Now it's like nicely set to use the rule. Sin of sin x over 2 divided by sin x over 2. But what about the limit? It's not this that we need. As x goes to 0, we know that sin x will also go to 0. So we can replace it by sin x goes to 0. If sin x goes to 0, sin x over 2 will also go to 0. Okay? So this limit as x goes to 0, you can change it to limit as sin x over 2 goes to 0. Now this part is nicely set to use the theorem. It's in the form, it's in the standard form. And the other part we will take separately. This, there's the remaining sin of sin x over 2. We will find the limit of that separately. We have in Karadarayak Nayabi. Limit as x goes to 2. Okay. Now, like everything is nicely set, you can find the answer. This part, the whole thing, by our theorem, it's like sin theta over theta, as theta goes to 0, so that will be equal to 1 into, this will give, as x goes to 0, sin x over 2 will go to 0, so we'll sin of that. So finally, it gives 0. Ultimately, the answer is 0. This is the answer. Hari kona ekak gala liyagat final the limit is 0. Okay, can I write the second question? You can write now. Not the second, it's the third today. Limit as t goes to zero, t goes to zero, it is root of 1 plus 1 over t square minus root of minus root of 1 over t square minus 1. Root of 1 over t square minus 1. 1 plus 1 over t square minus root of 1 over t square minus 1. This is the question. Is it right? I give you 2 or 3 minutes. Start it now. So, what is the static? I think it's better you simplify if we take in the common denominator. And we also, before doing anything, if the common denominator is t square, t also is t square. So, t square will come out of the root as t, 1 over t. Come out as 1 over t, so you can take it out of this also. 1 over t can be taken here. Limit as t goes to 0, it looks like 1 over t into, when you take t square common denominator here, that gives t square plus 1. Minus 1 minus t square. उसका बिल हो गया। वन माइनस टी स्क्वायर So in a case like this, what do you do next? Do you remember? It's square root of this minus square root of this. If you take the limit directly, that will give t will go to 0. It will be 1 minus 1. 1 minus 1, 0 in the numerator divided by 0. So it looks like 0 over 0. So you can't give that as the answer. You have to do something to get rid of that. Right? So we learned last day. In a case like this, our method is multiply and divide by changing the sign in the middle, right? So we write it as limit as t equals to 0, 1 over t into root of t square plus 1 minus root of 1 minus t square. We multiply and divide by changing the sign in the middle. Root of t square plus 1 plus root of 1 minus t square divided by the same. Root of t square plus 1 plus root of 1 minus t square. So now the denominator, sorry, the numerator is the difference of squares, and nagging up it is the denominator part, right? Nagging is the you can consider this part separately. In the numerator is the difference of squares. The numerator difference of squares, square of this minus square of this, right? So then the denominator separately, so that will give no problem with the denominator, root of t square plus 1 plus root of 1 minus t square. Okay, now what happens here? 1 gets cancelled, leaving 2t square over t. Limit as t goes to 0, you 2t square divided by t. And as you said earlier, we have no problem with this part. As t goes to 0, this will not give 0 or infinity, right? So therefore, you can take the limit directly of this part. So what happens when you take the limit? As t goes to 0, will be 1 plus another 1, t goes to 0, so it will be altogether 1 over 2, that will be half. Here the problem is t, so you can get rid of t. So leaving just t there, now the denominator will not go to 0, so it's just 2t. Limit as t goes to 0, it's 2t into half. So, as t goes to 0, this will give result 0. It's 0 into half, finally. 0 into half. Ultimately, the answer is half. That's what you get. Oh, sorry. 0 into half, Tiro. Tiranito half is zero. හරි කොහොමද කරන්නේ ලියා ගන්න දැන් අපිට පුළුවන් පාස් කරන්න මම හිත හොම්බත් දීපේ වගේ නේද හරි Okay, so finally we go to the homework, questions I give for homework, the first two are easy I think, first two I give for homework are easy, so you can quickly discuss them. Question number one, I give limit as x goes to 0. As x goes to 0, it, sin 5x plus sin 3x over 4x. Sin 5x plus sin 3x over 4x. So, first of all, you can take this 4 out, it will come out as 104 limit. So, we can separate. Okay, then, other ethical number, I'm making them only exceptions, right? So you can separate them with sine 4x or sine 5x over x. Plus here sine 3x over, I take it separately. Limit as sine 3x over x. Right? Sine 3x over x. But it's not x you would like to see. The denominator in this, because it's sin 5x here, to apply our theorem, it has to be 5x. So I write 5x because I want to see it there. I write And then to neutralize this 5, you have to multiply by 5. Multiply by 5. Here it's sine 3x over x, but to apply our theorem, it has to be 3x, not x. It has to be 3x. Right? And to neutralize this, I'll multiply by 3 and I'll write it outside the limit. Outside the limit. Now, here we have sine 5x over 5x. You are given limit x goes 0. But what we need is sine 5x over 5x. What we need is 5x goes to 0. But as x goes to 0, you see that 5x will also go to 0. So you can change this limit x goes to 0 to 5x goes to 0. Here again we have limit x goes to 0. But we like to see not x, 3x goes to 0. But really, when x goes to 0, 3x will also go to 0. Okay. Now we have like things nicely set here. So this thing by the theorem is equal to 1. This thing again, this part by the theorem is equal to 1. So it looks like 104, 5 into 1 plus 3 into 1. So it's 8 over 5, 4, finally the answer is 2. කොහොමද අරු බල තියෙනවා හදාන්න පුළුවන් ඕකේ නම් අරු පාඩුවක් වෙන දෙයක් නැහැ පොඩ්ඩක් දෙසි ගන්න ඕකේ අරු පාඩුවක් වුණා නම් වැරදි හදාන්න කලින් හරියට ඔක්ක කරගෙන යන්න ඕනේ and the next is question number 2 I gave limit as x goes to 0 sin 7x no rather cos 7x minus cos 3x divided by x. Cos 7x minus cos 3x divided by x. Again, did you notice that if you send x to 0, right, if x tends to 0, this will give 1 minus 1. So that will be 0 divided by 0. It looks like 0 divided by 0. So no meaning, no mathematical meaning. So therefore we have to do something to work it out, to find the exact limit. What we do here is, to our theorem is this sin x over x. As x goes to 0, the limit is equal to 1. That's why we have to make a line. සම්බන්ධ කරගන්න ඕනේ. So what we do is as in this cos minus cos the formula. ඊනෙන් දැක්කත් මේ වගේ එකක් මතක් වෙන්න ඕන අපි. නාන 400ක් විතර හදවල ඇත්තේ. Okay, so let's see. You see this? So within a pair should come into your mind. The formula cos minus cos is minus 2 sin sin. So it's minus 2 sin sin. Minus 2 sin sin and then divide by 2 will be 5x. Subtract and divide by 2 will be 2x. Divided by x. Now I take them separately. Here I have sin 2x. I can take this separately. This separately and minus 2 limit. But there is no extra, only extra. This extra I can take either in this or this. Can take a fit again. If I take with sin 5x, sin, it will be sin 5x over x. But it's not x time we like to see. It is 5x. To take with this, so I multiply by 5. Okay. And then we need that here we have x close to 0. I change it to 5x close to 0. Right? So, and then remaining this, I take the limit of that separately. Last day we wrote the rules of limits, but last day, some 2 days before. As x goes to 0, you have sine 2x, that is the other part. Now, by our theorem, this part is 1 minus 2 into 5 into 1. But as x goes to 0, here you have just sine 2x. Sine 2x, as x goes to 0, that will go to 0. So finally, not multiplication, yes. Finally, this into 0, whatever you get here, multiplied by 0, answer will be equal to 0. So the limit is 0. Because two questions. Okay, shall we go to the next? ඉලංග ගන්න කලින් මම ඔයගොල්ලන්ට මේ මතක් කරන්න ඕනේ නමයි සැරින් සැරේ කියන කතා කළා මේ ඩේටා ප්‍රශ්න ඩේටා ප්‍රශ්නේ ඉන්නේ සමහර අයට මේ දැන් මම හිතන වැඩි දෙනෙක්ගේ මල්ටි පැකේජස් තියෙනවා අර වෙනකට නම් පන්ති කරන්නේ නෙමෙයි පොඩි පොඩි දේවල් පාවිච්චි කරන එක මේ එක මදිනා ළමයි කැම්පේන් එකකට කතාලා පොඩ්ඩක් වැඩි කරගන්න පුතානක් කියලා ගන්න නේ නරඹ ගන්න ඉඳන් කරන්නත් එපා එක මේ කාර්තුලට පුරා දාලා එහෙම මේ ඉතින් දාගන්න දැන් එපා ගොඩාක් ඉඳන් යනවා මම කියන්නම් දැන් මයික්‍රොසොෆ්ට් එක මයිකන්නේ ඩයලොග් ඩයලොග් එකේ තියෙනවා රුපියල් 249 නේ මාසෙටම අන්ලිමිටඩ් යූටියුබ් අපි මේ යූටියුබ් නේ පන්ති කරන්නේ 249 කට මාසෙටම යන්නේ අන්ලිමිටඩ් තියෙනවා ඒලක එකක් දාගන්න මම දන තරමින් සෙට්ටි එකේ තියෙන එකක් සෙට්ටි එකේ තියෙනවා දෙකෙන් හරියට හොඳන්නේ මම ඔබිටෙල් එකක් බලන්න කියලා පුළුවන් බොහෝ විට ඒලක එකක් දාගන්න එතකොට මාසෙටම එකට ගියද මොකද 250ක් වගේ යන්නේ කොහොමද අපි අද කාලේ කීයද එහෙම නැතුව මොනවද සැන්සරේ කාඩ් පුරවගෙන දාලා හරියට ไอ้ตาดาขึ้นกันได้ป่ะไอ้เตรียมมาเนี่ยคือแล้วก็คือเตรียมมาแค่นั้นอันนี้ก็คือพันธุ์เตนาดาเตอร์มาดาก็จะได้อีกเรื่องนึงอันนี้ถ้าหอมตรงไหนเนี่ยมาเสร็จมาแต่คิดได้ดาเนี่ยก็ได้ตรงนี้แล้วก็เตรียมมาตรงนี้อันนี้ก็พันธุ์เตนาดาเตอร์มาดาก็จะได้อีกเรื่องนึงอันนี้ก็คือเตรียมมาแค่นั้นอันนี้ก็คือพันธุ์เตนาดาเตอร์มาดาก็จะได้อีกเรื่องนึงอันนี้ก็คือเตรียมมาตรงนี้อันนี้ก็คือพันธุ์เตนาดาเตอร์มาดาก็จะได้อีกเรื่องนึง I especially wanted to see how you did these things. Number three, in it as x close to pi by 2. Pi by 2, I give you 1 minus sin x over x minus pi by 2. Anybody have to do this? Found the answer? If anybody solve this, please show the answer. What's the word for the answer? Karambulam Nadalatari. If so, what did you get for the answer finally? If so, I'll give a hint, then you can start with that and proceed from there. Okay, I'll give some hint. Here you can, it's like 1 minus sin x. 1 and sin x, like they do not match, right, together. But you can replace this 1 by, right, this 1 by the sin of pi by 2. If you want, you can replace this 1 by sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2. And then proceed from that. Right. What am I going to do? Then I'm going to do it. Then I'm going to do it. Then I'm going to do it. What we do is replace this 1 by sin pi by 2.
Thank you.
Instead of answer zero, anybody? Okay, let's see. And now, that was done. Can I get another one? Again, seeing this should come into your mind. Hmm? And so, let me rename that as now. Sine minus sine is the formula. Sine minus sine is 2 cos sine. X goes to pi by 2. 2 cos sine. And then divide by 2. B pi by 2 plus 6 divided by 2 into subtract and divide by 2, pi by 2 minus 6 divided by 2 over we have x minus pi by 2, right? But here you see something like pi by 2 minus x divided by 2. Pi by 2 minus x. In the denominator is x minus pi by 2. But better we have something similar to this. So you can change this. Change this to pi by 2 minus x. Just taking a minus 1 out. So we will write minus 1 here. Just write minus here. And switch these two terms. Pi by 2 minus 6. Okay. And now we can take them separately. Sine pi by 2 minus x divided by 2 with this. So we'll take that part separately. Minus limit, we will adjust the limit. Seeing what I'm getting here. Sine of, you get pi by 2 minus x divided by 2. And here we have pi by 2 minus x. Again, you would like to see that divided by 2. So you don't need to bring a 2 from outside. Here we have a 2. We can send it there. Understand that? Metal divot. These 2 we will take down. Now, we have this, that part nicely, but the limit, what happens to the limit, what do we need there? It's sine pi by 2 minus x over 2. And here also pi by 2 minus x over 2. To apply the rule, the theorem that we have, it has to be, this thing goes to 0. Pi by 2 minus x over 2 goes to 0. That's when you can use the rule. But x goes to pi by 2, when x goes to pi by 2, what happens to this? Pi by 2 minus x? If x gets close to pi by 2, then pi by 2 minus x will get closer to 0. So you divide by 2, no change, then it will go to 0, much bigger, right? So x goes to pi by 2, you can replace by pi by 2 minus x divided by 2 goes to 0. Here now, everything is nicely set to use the rule. But we have another part, so we take it separately. Limit as x goes to 0, you have cos of pi by 2 plus x divided by 2. So there is minus 1 outside into this whole part. This whole part by our theorem is just 1 into. What about this part? You can take the limit of that directly as x goes to pi by 2. It gives something like pi by 2 plus pi by 2 divided by 2. So it looks like cos of pi by 2. Cos of pi by 2 is 0. So this part, the limit of this part is 0 because it gets close to cos of pi by 2. So it's 0. Finally, you are multiplying by 0, whatever you have here, finally it is 0. The answer is 0. Okay, can we go to the next now? Next question I gave is the next sum. Next sum I gave is limit as x goes to 0. This may be number 4. Limit as x goes to 0. Cos to the power 4x minus sine to the power 4x. Here minus 1 is also there. Minus 1 divided by x squared. Right? So that's the next question I give. So I think this is not that hard. I think you can do this, right? Anybody finish this? What is the answer you got? What is the answer to this? What is the limit here? N baran hadupai? What you got for this? What is the answer for this? So it's easy to start, it's easy to decide how to start it. It's easy to decide how to start it. To use the our formula as S2 says who is Dhani Goda, Dhani Goda how is Khavi Chanevi Neda? Can you do Dina Rane? Matamatakane, who is Dhani Goda? Matamatakane, Alava? Your answer is minus 2, okay, let's see. Any other answer? Oh, the other sentence is this. Okay, let's start with it's Linara. Okay, Linara. Let's see whether it's correct or not. What about the others? Linara says it's minus 2. What about the others? Not right? Right. You can start by factoring this by difference of squares. So it's cos star x plus sin star x into cos star x minus sin star x minus 1 divided by x squared. And this part is equal to 1. So you can forget it. And it reduces to, the numerator reduces to limit as x goes to 0. It gives cos squared x minus sin squared x minus 1 divided by x squared. Right? Our theorem is for sin x over x. So you don't need a cos square here. You don't need a cos square here. You can replace it by this cos square x. You can replace by 1 minus sin square x. Okay? 1 minus sin square x. So 1 will cancel with this, giving minus sin square x. Altogether, the numerator will be reduced to minus 2 sin square x. Right? And you take minus 2 out, it will look as sin squared x divided by x squared. Okay? If you replace this cos squared x by 1 minus sin squared x, the whole numerator will reduce to minus 2 sin squared x. And now we will rewrite this. Inara, Baran, the next step in Harry River together. You can't say this is equal to 1 because that's not how it is the theorem. You have to rewrite this to apply our theorem. Everything, last year also I told you, everything should be nicely said. It should be in the form as much in the theorem. So we will write limit as x goes to 0, sine x over x. And it's the square of whole thing. Now it's nicely said. Now you can say by the theorem, this is 1 and 1 square. So it's minus 2 into 1. Your answer is correct. Minus 2 into 1. So it's minus 2. Finally, the limit is minus 2. It's correct. Next step is clear. Now the balance. Ek avashyai. Okay, can go to next. And the next question is, next sum is limit as x goes to pi by 4. This may be number 5. Limit as x goes to pi by 4, it is cos to the power of 5x minus sin to the power of 5x. Divided by cos 2x. I think many of you could do that. I'll give some hint so you can use that and then easily finish. Right? This is what. We use something you can use in a problem like this. Factoring, say you have a square minus b square in all your children, you can take a minus b out. A minus b is a factor, the other factor is b plus b. Right? Then you take a cube minus b cube. Still, you can take a minus b as a factor, you can take it out. And the rest will be a square plus ab plus b square. Right? So likewise, if for any integer n, for any positive integer n, from an minus bn, you can take a minus b out. So a minus b is a factor of any an minus bn, and n has to be a positive integer. You can prove this using even the factor theorem. Using even the factor theorem, you can prove that this is it. But this what we are going to write is itself a proof also, right? Then what is the rest? Once you take a minus b out, what's the other factor or the quotient? Nice. You need a in here. To get a in, we multiply, we write a to the power n minus 1. And multiply these two, that will produce a. Okay? Then, but there is an unwanted term here. Minus b, a to the power n minus 1. We don't need this. And then get rid of that. Right? So we have to get rid of that. To get rid of that term, obviously, it's a negative term. To get rid of that, we add something. Like that something, we add here. It is, whatever we write here should produce plus b into a to the power n minus 1. So for which we write b into a to the power n minus 2. As you write b into a to the power n minus 2, these two will produce what we wanted here. Yeah? This will give you b into a to the power n, not b into a to the power n. Yes, rather n minus 1. But when you multiply these two, so that will produce minus b square n a to the power n minus 2. එක බොරුවක් වහගන්න තව බොරු කියන්නේ නේද මේ ඔබමැටික් අයින් කරන්න ටර්මිනල් ලිව්වම ඒක අයින් වුණාට අලුත් හතරදරයක් එනවා ඒක අයින් කරනකොට අලුත් හතරදරයක් එනවා බොරු කියන්නේ යාමත් ඒ වගේ එකක් වහගන්න තව එකක් කියනවා ඒක වහගන්න තව එකක් කියනවා ඒක වරක් නැති වෙනවා එතන ඔබමැටික් බොරුනෝ කියනවා බට් බොරු කියන ගත්තොත් කෙලවරක් නැහැ හොඳේ But this is not mathematics, this is mathematics, not lying. So here we have an n to this. So next term will be b square. So if we write the next term, b square a to the power n minus 3. Then as you proceed like that, so finally it will be, here you see that there is no b term, b to the power 0. B to the power 1, B to the power 2, B to the power 3. So ultimately it has to be to produce B to the power n. It has to be there is B also, B to the power plus B to the power n minus 1. Now these two will produce B to the power n. So one at the other side of point in n. Right? So that's how it's in mathematics. A to the power n minus b to the power n, from this a to the power n minus b to the power n, you can always take a minus b a factor out. And this is the quotient. You can use this. Yeah, you can use it for that sum. Udawa dunnama vinadi kiyata denna hamama karagadan. Ikpanin karagannada. Hari? These questions are given for part A. In part A, for short questions, you should be able to work out in around 4 minutes. Ikpanin karagadan hamama. Once I apply this, yeah, this start to talk to the power 5x minus 9 to the power 5x. This factor is going to get to be cos to the power 4x plus sine x into cos to the power 3x plus sine square x cos square x plus sine cube x cos x and finally sine to the power 4x. Then what to do with this denominator cos 2x? Cos 2x is the denominator, right? to simplify with this, obviously it should come in your mind, cos 2x, you can replace by the formula, cos squared x minus sin squared x. So I write it at the same time in practice. Cos 2x equals cos squared x minus sin squared x, and you can write it in factors. You can cos square cos x minus sin x, then cos x plus sin x. Okay, and now you see that name is another car in the denominator and numerator, right? So this is what produces zero in the numerator, and the same thing produces zero in the denominator. Right? Okay, car the අයින් කරන්න පුළුවන් නේ අර්ධර කාර්යයෙන් වල යනවා ඕකේ and now no problem you can take the limit directly in both numerator and denominator so here plus 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 never zero the numerator here again plus never zero the denominator right so you can take the limit directly to give some answer now see your answer take the limit and find the answer. Did you notice this? As x goes to pi by 4, x goes to pi by 4, it's like cos to the power 4 pi by 4. Here sin pi by 4 and cos pi by 4 to the power 3. So, but the values are the same. Cos pi by 4 or sin pi by 4 are the same. So this gives 1 over root 2 to the power 4. This will also give 1 over root 2 to the power 4. So till this 1 over root 2 to the power 4. Because it's 1 over pi by 4, right? Here also 1 over root 2 to the power 4. So each of these terms will produce separately 1 over root 2 to the power 4. So you can directly write. There are five such terms, 1 over root 2 to the power 4, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 such terms. So the numerator will be equal to 5 into 1 over root 2 to the power 4. The denominator, 1 over root 2 plus 1 over root 2. So there will be 2 over root 2. And what happens finally in this 5 over so root 2 to the power 4 root 2 to the power 4 is 4 and this will give a root 2 another root 2 so finally it will be 5 over 4 root 2 this is the answer finally it's the limit Here the denominator is 1 over root 2 plus 1 over root 2, so it is 2 over root 2, numerator, all these are producing the same, 1 over root 2 to the power 4, 1 over root 2 to the power 4, there are 5 such terms, so that's why I wrote 5 into 1 over root 2 to the power 4, as x goes to pi by 4. You don't see the last term here, it's sine to the power 4x, right? Here the last term was plus sine to the power 4x. Okay, so shall we go to the next question? The next time I give for homework, number 6. Take it around now, number 6. Limit as x goes to 0, 1 plus x minus cos x divided by sin x. At last, you see that x over sin x is there. This thing needs to separate that. So you can simplify that part easily. X over sin x, then remain 1 minus cos x over sin x. Right? So you separate them as x over sin x plus as x goes to 0. 1 minus cos x over sin x. This you can find easily. This gives just one. I have here. What about this? 1 minus cos x over sin x. Minus cos x, that also we have seen cos inverse, 1 minus cos x, you know what to do with that, right? This can be replaced by 2 sin square x over 2 by our formula for cos 2x. This can be replaced by, we did it once today, this can be replaced by 2 sin squared x over 2, right? Since there is sin x over 2 in the numerator, this denominator sin x, this also can be expressed in half angles two sin x over 2 plus x over 2. Now here these things will get cancelled, leaving only as x goes to 0, numerator is sin x over 2, denominator cos x over 2. Zero divided by one. Or tan x over 2 goes to 0, right? If you want, you can without this, you can write tan x over 2. So that goes to 0. 1 plus 0, finally the limit is 1. That's the answer. Ilangakam goda lazy, I'll skip that and I'll go to the last question. Ilangaka lazy vedi okonot karagan puluwan innaki. So let's go to the last question I gave. First you can finish it. So this was the last question I gave you. Limit as x goes to test question number 7. X goes to 0. 1 plus x minus cos x divided by, oh no, sorry, not that. It is root of 9 plus x square minus 3 divided by root of 16 plus sine square x minus 4. Anybody finish this and got the answer? So what is it? What is the answer of this? What is the limit finally? This one? Sir, can you give me the answer? How do you make it? What is the answer? Oh, how much do you have? How many comments do you have also? I'm not knowing. You know how to start this, very clearly you know how to start it because 4-3 says, again Linara says 4-3, when I'm out of that, you know? Am I coming here or not? I'm going to start the game, I'm coming here or not? I'm going to start the game, And that's another answer. Sachin says it's 1. Let's see. It's 4-3-0-1-0, anything else. Malam Rasallah. So you know how to get rid of these situations. S square root, then a hard graph, you know, we can be in a negative unknown, another be in the denominator. We have the technique to get rid of something like this. There are two such things. If you consider this, we will multiply and divide by changing the sign of this in the middle. So multiply divided by root of 9 plus x square plus 3. Again, root of 9 plus x square plus 3. We learned this method long ago. And then here is another problem in the denominator. Right? To deal with this, we multiply and divide by changing the sign in the middle here. Right? So multiply divided by root of 16 plus sin square x plus 2 divided by root of 16 plus sin square x plus 4. Now you take these two together and these two together. So given the difference of square in both numerator and denominator, you can have it is a carburet method in it, no? Nagin carburet in the numerator, Nagin carburet in the denominator. So these parts we take separately, right? So that's something we did very early in this section. Okay, you take these two separately so that you difference of squares, square of this minus square of this, 9 plus x square minus 9. Here, take these two, again difference of squares, and you 16 plus sin square x minus 16 into the other two parts we take separately. This one 16 plus sin square x plus 4 divided by this. Thank you. here nine gets cancelled, 16 gets cancelled, leaving x star over sin square x, that part separately. So it looks like limit x goes to 0. So sin x whole thing square, that's how we have to write it. And what happens here? Has x goes to 0. This will go to 0, giving 4 plus 4, 8. Divided by, this will go to, as x goes to 0, 3 plus 3, 6. It's equal to 1. And simplify this. 4, 3. Yeah, finally the answer is 4 over 3. Lira's answer is correct. Yeah, that is the answer. And in addition to this, I told you to do all the past paper sums from 2011. Then topic of formula discussed on the Vela of Nayad. Then a pekak hadamu. Open and how the animal abunani had the Ganaka the Tautica. Total Nesatia Triker and Meganan ticket from 2011. Then the Vela thing I had here. The Nekak Kadana 2011 question is very easy. You can try that. 2012, this is also easy. So we can discuss it now. 2012. If you can give a mobile hunter and that, it's a past name. I'm not very on the other thing. I'm not even about this. If not, by next lesson, we can start differentiating. Okay. Right, so shall we go to take a 2012 question? Amar Nayaka. ඊට කලින් මම මේයි කියන ළමයි දැන් මේ තීන තත්ත්ව යටතේ අපිට විසාපයක් නැහැ නේ ලබන සතිය හරි ඊළඟ සතිය හරි වෙනකොට අපිට සාමාන්‍ය විදිහට කන්ස පටන් ගන්න පුළුවන් වෙයි කියලා. ඒත් මේ තත්ත්වේ තාකිරතාව තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. අපි අපේ වැඩ කරගෙන යමු. ඔකලෝ කම්බල වෙන්නේ නැහැ මපා. මැක්ස් විශේෂයෙන්ම මේ ඔකලෝ කරගෙන මැක්ස් අප්ඩේට් මැක්ස් ෆිසික්ස් කෙමිස්ට්‍රි වගේවා සම්බන්ධ වෙලා ටික දවසක් අතාරලා දාන්න එපා. अभी පාස්ටි එකක් තරම් අදන් වෙලා ඉඳගෙන පන්ති ටිකක් දැක්කත් කොහොමගේ ආයි කරන්න නිකන් ඉඳලාට ඒ දණන් අදලා කාලෙන් කාලෙ නිකන් අපයවන්න එපා කාලෙ ප්‍රයෝජන ගන්න ඕන වැඩ ගන්න ඕන මොලේ කියුම් කරලා තියා ගන්න ඕන ඒක මේ නිකන් මලකට ගන්න දෙන්න එපා හරි තාපි ග්‍රාහකක් අපිට මෙහෙම යන්න දෙන්නේ එක දෙයක් නෙමෙයි මොලේ තින්දු කියලා නැත්නම් මනාවද තීත්‍රා වෙන විදිහට ඉන්නේ ඒක කරලා2003. You asked to know that limit as limit as x goes to zero. Limit as x goes to zero. Sin x divided by 2 sin square 3x minus x square cos x. You have to show that this is equal to 1 over 17. That's the task to show that this limit is equal to 1 over 17. ළමයි ඔක දැක් හැටි මනන්න මතක් වෙන්නේ සමහර අය කරලා ඇති කරපු නැති අය වුණා බැලු බැලු වල පේනවා මොනවද කරන්නේ කියලා sin x divided by 2 sin square 3x minus x square cos x so how to start this කරපු අය හරි කරපො නැති අය හරි කමක් නැහැ ගන්න. What's the first step? You can easily decide how to start it. මේක දැන් බලමු හිතා ගන්න පුළුවන්. How you start it? කියන බලන්න කරපු අය නැත්තම් बैलून No idea. You can easily decide what to do. Have to start this. අර නැක්කා වගේ අපි ළඟ තියෙනවා මේ ටූල් එකක් ඒක පාවිච්චි කරන්න ඕනේ ඒක වෙනම සම්බන්ධ කර ගන්න ඕනේ. ද තියරම් අපිට කනෙක්ට් කිව්වේ. To connect the road with this, best thing to do, divide everything by x square. All the terms by x square, so it will do sin x over x, sin square 3x over x square, e x square will cancel, giving just cos x. So you simplify, you divide everything by x square. So that you, I take separately the numerator, limit as x goes to 0, dividing by x square and x will cancel, giving sin x over x. Sin x over x. In this one, you can keep 2 out and take the limit separately. Limit as x goes to 0. That give sin 3x over x whole thing square. Okay, you are dividing by x square. That give sin 3x over x and start a whole thing, but it's not sin 3x over x you would like to see. But you'd like to see 3x here. So we'll change it to 3x. This is that we have taken externally. Then to neutralize that, you will have to multiply by not 3 but by 9 because it's squared here. So you have to multiply by 9. Multiply by 9, okay? Because you have like imported the 3 square. Then what about this? As you divide by x square, then you just cos x. Okay. Now you can take the limit. This gives 1. So will this, as x goes to 0, cos x will also give 1. So altogether you have like 1 divided by 2 into 9, 18, minus here also 1. So it's 1 over 17. So that's the answer. So once you divide by x, divide all the terms by x square, so it will like open the door. හරි ඉතර අමාරු නෑ පේනවා නේද මම ගණන් හදන්න එනාදී 3කින් නැගේ 4කට අඩු කාලෙකින් හදාන්න පුළුවන් වෙන මොන වෙනද හරි නේද රමයි හරි ලියා ගන්න බැරුණා නම් පුළුවන් පස්සට ඇදලා ලියා ගන්න ඊට පස්සේ so we can finish the class today and you can try all the other past papers from 2011 up to 2019 so you mark if you find anything hard and you can discuss them the next day man hitanne wedi hariya kohoma karanna puluwane amare yawanna karanne wedi anyway if you have any question we can discuss next day and start differentiation a very important topic in mathematics right differentiation so hopefully we can start it by the next lesson එහෙනම් ළමයි දැනට ඔය ගණන් ටික හදන්න වැඩ කරලා කියන්න අපි ඊළඟට හම්බ වෙමු එහෙනම් Thursday ඕකලන්ට උදසන්නයි නිරෝගී සුවය ප්‍රාර්ථනා කරනවා